Welcome to Buy Hold Sell, brought to you by Livewire Markets. My name is Matthew Kidman, and today I'm joined by David Wilson from First Sentier and Michelle Lopez from abrdn. And reporting season's over, and we're going to have a look at what smashed, and we're going to have a look at a couple of stocks that crashed. So FN Arena has given us three stocks that we're going to look at that did exceptionally well, and then the team beside me is going to have a look at those ones that, well, they disappointed. Start with you, David. WiseTech, big technology, global logistics, cracker result, great outlook, buy, hold or sell?
It's a buy, top end of guidance. They continue to grow internationally. They've now got three of the top freight forwarding companies on with contracts, and yeah, great outlook.
Michelle, it's on about 1,000 times earnings, but it's been a terrific company, keeps growing, buy, hold or sell?
It's a hold for us for the reasons. I think this is one of the highest quality tech names, and they have executed impeccably, but on the valuation it's on today, it's a hold.
Right, okay, let's get to healthcare. One of the older stocks did quite well, pathology, Sonic Healthcare, buy, hold or sell?
Sonic is a hold as well, and this is a really well-run business, but they're facing into some real headwinds from an earnings projection and trajectories down, and the reason for that is the COVID testing. That represents 25% of their revenue still, and it's much higher margin than their underlying business. So unfortunately, they can't make it up even as well run as it is, so it's a hold at these levels.
Great result, David, but bring back the good old days of COVID. Buy, hold or sell?
I agree with Michelle. It's a very well-run company, but we have it as a sell. We think that the earnings dip that they're going to take over the next year or two, because of the way the volumes were brought forward through COVID, means that the earnings will come under pressure. So for us, a sell.
Okay, market sell-off earlier this year, Pinnacle Investment Management got torched. Great result, bounce back, buy, hold or sell?
For us, it's a buy, actually. One of the few fund managers that are actually getting inflows. They've got a well-diversified group of portfolio managers on their team, and they're continuing to getting inflows both internationally and from retail in Australia. So for us, it's a buy.
Incredible job. They just seem to pour that money into their managers. Buy, hold or sell, Michelle?
Well, it's a buy for us too. And you know, you're only as good as your last performance, but fortunately it's a partial truism in our industry. But for Pinnacle, they've got their model to that point that there's different styles, there's different managers, so that key risk around performance of markets can be mitigated. And the other thing I'd say is they've got a lot of capacity within their current affiliates that they can grow into. We're starting to see the flows come through. And that distribution platform, it's really unparalleled in our market, and they can export that offshore. So I think there's still, you know, caveat being very volatile, there's a lot of leverage to the beta, to beta in the market within that name. But if you can sail through, I think it's one to buy.
They're kicking into gear. Okay, we've had the good times. What didn't do so well that worried you during reporting season?
Look, I think the disappointment for us was ASX, actually. And ASX is, you know, one of those really high quality defensive names, but it disappointed from a cost perspective, both OPEX and CAPEX. They've got CHESS, which is the blockchain settlement system that they're trying to roll out. That got delayed again. And they've had some, you know, key management changes. You've had, in a very short space of time, CEO, CFO and head of listings all leaving the organisation at a really critical point. So we think, just looking forward, there's a lot of sort of risk factors that haven't played out yet. So that was the disappointment for us.
David, sounds like even monopolies can have a bad go at it. What was the one that caught your eye that you walked away?
I would also say that I agree with Michelle. We actually thought ASX was very disappointing as well. But even more disappointing for us was Coles. They continue to sort of lag Woolworths in terms of market share. They're lagging them in terms of CapEx and their sort of online development of their business. So for us, that was, you know, particularly disappointing.
There's not a stronger word in the English language than disappointing, but luckily, those things were okay during reporting season. If you enjoyed listening to these two guests, David and Michelle, as much as I did, give it a thumbs up, give it a like, and don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel for heaps of more really interesting content.